Hello friends, what's up? Welcome in the world of Maths by Amiya. This concept video is the extension of the previous video. I would suggest please watch the previous video. The link is in front of you. In this video, we directly discuss quotient because we have learned concepts. We just applied those concepts in this concept video. Our question is, sum of few positive numbers is 20. Then we have to find the maximum product. The quotient is in front of you. This quotient is almost similar to the last concept video question. In this, the question is sum of few positive numbers, and in the last concept video it was sum of few positive integers. The question is sum common, positive common, few common. The only difference is integers and numbers. If we have integers, we work on 2 and 3, but if we have numbers, then we do not work on 2 and 3. We only work on E. Why I am working on E, please check. If we are working with sum of few positive integers, if the question is sum of few positive integers is nothing but 30, we are working integers and positive is 30. So according to our previous concept video or the concept of x raised to power x, for the integer x would be 3. So we work on this is nothing but 3, how many times? 10 times is 30. If we add 3, 10 times, then it becomes 30, and the product is what? 3 raised to power 10, because 3, 10 times. Can we write it is nothing but 3 raised to power 1 by 3 raised to power 30, or this is nothing but 3 raised to power 30 by 3. This is a maximum integral product, but here the question is, we need to find positive numbers. If the question is not the integer, if the question is positive, then we are not working on 3 or 2, believe me. Only difference between that concept video and this concept video is the positive and the positive integer. That one is for the positive integer and this one is for the positive numbers. For the positive integers, we have to work either on 3 or 2, but 3 maximum times. If your question is only positive, then we are not working on either 3 or 2. We are working on x is equal to e. For the 3, this was 30 raised to power. If we are working for the 3, that is 3, 1 by 3 raised to power 30. If the question is sum of positive numbers only, not integers, is 30, then we are not working on 30. We are working on e, 1 by e raised to power 30, and this is our maximum product. This is the learning of this concept video. In the previous video, for the sum of few positive integers, we work on 3 and 2. In this concept video, the learning is if the question is sum of few positive numbers, then we work on e raised to power 1 by e, into summation. This is our answer. Now solve our question. Our question is sum of few positive numbers is 20 and we need to find the maximum product's integral value. Since summation of few positive numbers, not the integers, is 20, then the product max is e 1 raised to power e raised to power 20. E 1 raised to power e give the max value and 20 is the given summation. And why e? Because we are working on a positive numbers. If it's integer, then we should work on either 3 or 2, 3 maximum times. So we have to work on this, and according to quotient, this one is p. We are not looking for the b, we are looking for the integral value of p. How do we find the integral value of p? Without calculation, it is not possible. Or we can do approximation, but I have written use calculator. CAT and other computer examination provides you calculator. So we have to use calculator. So first we have to calculate e raised to power 20 by e. This becomes e raised to power 20 by e. And if we solve this, our calculator shows 1568.05 ... And we are not looking for this value. We are looking for the integral value. So the integral value of this one is nothing but 1568. If your calculator has e, work on this. If your calculator does not have e, then work like 2.71 raised to power 20 divided by 2.71. And if we solve this value, we will get 1568.0 something, and this is integral is 1568. I hope it is clear. So the learning behind this video is if your question is of few positive integers, then work on 3 and 2. And if your question is of few positive numbers, work on E. I hope it is clear. Even if you have any doubt, feel free to ping me. Thank you and happy learning.